The line-of-sight behavior can be used to determine if two objects can see each other. In other words, they are in range of each other, and there are no obstacles in the way blocking their line of sight. Let's take a look at how to get an object set up with a line-of-sight behavior. In this layout, we have a player object with the line of sight behavior applied. We also have some tree objects and some building objects. The building objects have the solid behavior applied to them, and they will act as obstacles to the player's line of sight. Obstacles will block the line of sight. If I select the player, under the line of sight properties, we have obstacles. Right now it's set to solids, which means that all solid objects will be considered obstacles. You can set it to custom and then define each object that you want to be an obstacle in the event sheet. We also have a tree object, which has two animations, unseen and seen. Unseen is the default animation, and it's just the regular tree. Seen is the tree with a green highlight around it. Currently, the player is controlled by the arrow keys with the 8-direction behavior, and she always faces the mouse cursor. What I want to do is have the trees switch to the scene animation when the player has them within her line of sight. So let's switch over to the event sheet. I'll create a new event using the player object, since it has the line of sight behavior applied to it. Scroll down to the line of sight category, and we have two options: has line of sight to object and has line of sight to position. With position, we can choose if the player has a line of sight to the specific X and Y coordinates in the layout, which is not what we want at this time. We want line of sight to object. Next, we can choose the object that we want to find out if it's within the player's line of sight, and we'll choose the tree. So this event will fire off when the player has the line of sight to the tree. Click Add Action, select the tree, and choose Set Animation. We want to change the tree's animation to scene whenever the player has line of sight with a tree. So enter scene for the animation. Next, we want to change back to the unseen animation when the line of sight is broken. Let's copy and paste the entire event, and then we'll just make some alterations. First, right-click the new event and select Invert. This will cause the event to trigger when the player loses line of sight to a tree. Then, double-click on the action and change the animation to unseen. Now we can preview the layout and everything should work. When the player looks at a tree and it's not obstructed, the tree is highlighted. If she walks over here, behind these buildings, the trees on the other side are obstructed, and even though they are within her range of sight, because they are obstructed, they are not highlighted. There are a few properties for the line of sight behavior that we need to discuss. We've already covered obstacles, but next is range. Range is the distance in pixels that the character can see. Currently, our player can see 600 pixels in front of her. But if I set it to 300, her range of vision will be cut in half. If I preview the layout, you can see the trees only get highlighted if they're within her range. Trees outside of the 300 pixel range are not within her line of sight. Next, we have cone of view. Cone of view is what determines how much peripheral vision the object has. Cone of view is set in degrees, forming a circle around the object. Currently, it's set to 120, which means the player's field of vision consists of a cone 60 degrees right and 60 degrees left to the front of the player. If we set it to 180, she can see everything in front of her, but nothing behind. If set to 360, she can see in all directions. With cone of view set to 360, she doesn't need to face the trees, she just needs to be within her range of vision. That's all there is to using the line of sight behavior. There are so many great uses for this behavior. I'm sure you're already getting ideas of how this could be implemented, whether it's a system like we've set up here today, or an enemy AI system that pursues you once you've been spotted, the possibilities are endless. Have fun experimenting with this behavior and see what you can come up with.